Company A is deciding whether to place a high bid of $18 million or a low bid of $12 million for leasing rights to a mining site. A major competitor, Company B, is also bidding for the same leasing rights. There is a 0.2 probability that Company B will place a $15 million bid and a 0.8 probability that they will place a $9 million bid. Preliminary examination of the site indicates a 0.2 probability of large deposits with net returns of $140 million, a 0.32 probability of moderate deposits with $50 million net returns, and a 0.48 probability of no deposits. The company that wins the bid will incur additional $10 million in extraction costs. How should Company A bid? What is the expected value of the decision? I'm going to begin with a decision node with branches for Company A options. They can either bid $18 million or $12 million. If they bid $18 million, Company A will win the bid since Company B bids are below $18 million. We could introduce a chance node here for Company B bidding $15 million or $9 million, but the result will be the same since Company A will win the bid either way. So we skip that and move on to the three states of nature that Company A will face if they win. We have large deposits with a probability of 0.2 and net return of $140 million, moderate with probability of 0.32 and net returns of $50 million, and no deposits with probability of 0.48 and zero net return. Now, winning the bid will require paying the $18 million plus additional extraction costs of $10 million. That is, we need to subtract $28 million from these returns. Therefore, for large, $140 minus 28 gives $112 million. For moderate, we have $50 minus 28, which gives $22 million. And for none, we have $0 minus $28 million, which gives negative $28 million. We can calculate the expected value for this decision by taking 0.2 times 112 plus 0.32 times 22 plus 0.48 times negative 28, and that gives $16 million. Note that we could have obtained the same result by calculating the expected values of the net returns, which will give $44 million. And on subtracting the $28 million, we will have $16 million. Now, if Company A bids $12 million, we know that Company B can bid $15 million with 0.2 probability and $9 million with 0.8 probability. This node is represented with a circle because the branches have probabilities associated with them. If Company B bids $15 million, Company A will be bidding lower than Company B at $12 million. Hence, Company B will win the bid, and consequently, the net return for Company A will be zero. Now, if Company B bids $9 million, Company A will win the bid since they're bidding higher at $12 million. So, Company A again will be exposed to the three states of nature we see up here for winning the bid. Company A will now pay $12 million for winning the bid, plus the additional $10 million extraction cost, totaling $22 million. The payoff for large will thus be $140 minus 22, which gives $118 million. For moderate, we have $50 minus 22, which gives $28 million. And for none, we have $0 minus 22, which gives negative $22 million. The expected value at this node will be 0.2 times 118 plus 0.32 times 28 plus 0.48 times negative 22, which gives $22 million. Since this is a chance node and not a decision node, we're not going to choose between 0 and $22 million. Instead, we calculate an expected value. So we have 0.2 times 0 plus 0.8 times 22, which gives $17.6 million. Finally, at this decision node, we choose between bidding $18 million and $12 million. Since the expected value of 17.6 is higher than 16 million, the optimal decision is to bid 12 million, and the expected value of the decision is 17.6 million. And that's it. Thanks for watching.